This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to do three word problems that are like the ones you typically run into when you're learning about similar triangles. So here's the first kind of problem. This one usually involves the height of an object. So it might be a tree. In this case, I'm going to use a flagpole. So let's say we've got a flagpole, and it's standing straight up. It's forming a right angle with the ground. It's a sunny day, and the sun is shining on the flagpole, and it's casting a shadow which is 30 feet long. Nearby, there's a man. He's standing straight up. He's 6 feet tall, and he's got a shadow that's 4 feet long. Now, the first thing I want to show is that we really have two similar triangles. The sun is shining down on this at the same angle on both the flagpole and the man. So we can draw kind of a picture of the angle that the sun is forming with the flagpole and the man by drawing a dotted line from the top of the flagpole to what would be the top of the shadow, and another line from the man's head to the shadow of the man's head. So now I've got two similar triangles. They're both right triangles, so that's one pair of congruent angles, and they both have the same angle at the top where the sun shines down in them. So I've got two pairs of congruent angles, which means I have two similar triangles. I can now find the height of the flagpole. To do that, I'm going to use the fact that for similar triangles, the proportions, the sides, are proportional. So the height of the flagpole is one side, and I'll compare that. I'll make a ratio between that side, h, and the height of the man, which is 6. And that should be equal to the ratio of the length of the flagpole's shadow, which is 30, over the length of the man's shadow, which is 4. So I've got h over 6 equals 30 over 4. I'll multiply both sides of this equation by 6 and get h equals 6 times 30 is 180. That's over 4. Dividing 180 by 4, I find out that the height of the flagpole is 45 feet. Okay, so once again, I showed that these two triangles were similar by showing that they had angle-angle similarity. Once I've got the fact that they're similar, I can find out what the length of a missing side is by using the fact that the sides are proportional. Okay, here's another kind of problem. This kind of problem, we've got a lake, and you're trying to find out the length of the lake from one end to the other without actually getting into the water. So I'm going to call one end of the lake A and the other end B, and here's what we're going to do. Starting at point A, you walk 100 feet to some point which we'll call point P, and then you continue walking 50 feet more to a point that we'll call C. You go over to the other end of the lake, point B, walk 70 feet until you get to point P, and then walk 35 feet more to point D. You measure the distance from C to D, and that's 40 feet. Now, if we can show that we have similar triangles, we can use these measurements to find out what the length of the lake is from A to B. So let's show that they're similar triangles. I want to show the triangle APB is similar to triangle CPB. So I want to see if I have two pairs of sides that are proportional. Well, I can take side AP, which is 100 feet, and put that over side CP, which is 50 feet. That's a pair of corresponding sides. And I'll make another fraction with side BP, 70 feet, over side DP, its corresponding side, which is 35 feet. I'll set those fractions equal to each other, and I'll make sure they're equal. 100 over 50 is the same as 2 over 1, and 70 over 35 is the same as 2 over 1. So the proportions are the same, which means I've got two pairs of corresponding sides that are proportional. Now, there's an angle that those sides form. That's angle P in both cases. Angle P is actually a pair of vertical, we've got a pair of vertical angles there. So what I've got is two pairs of similar sides and a pair of angles, the vertical angles, that are congruent. That means I've got two similar triangles. Let's use that fact to figure out what the distance is from A to B. So let's say that the distance from A to B is, we'll call that L for lake. The corresponding distance for L would be 40. That's the corresponding side of the other triangle. And we want to set that, we've got a ratio, L over 40, set that equal to the ratio for the other sides, which is just 2 over 1. So L over 40 equals 2 over 1. If I multiply both sides of this equation by 40, I'll get L equals 80. So the length of the lake is 80 feet. Once again, two similar triangles. I proved they were similar by using side angle, side similarity. And then I was able to find the unknown side. Okay, here's the third kind of problem. This usually involves a canyon or a river. You want to find the distance from one side of the river to the other. So let's say you're standing at point A on one side of the river, and you notice that directly across from you there's a tree. We're going to call that point B. So to do this, to find the distance across the river, you turn 90 degrees and walk along the length of the river 15 feet. After 15 feet, you put some marker down, which we'll call point P. And then you continue walking 10 feet more. Now you turn 90 degrees again, away from the river, walk 8 feet. Okay, I'm sorry, I should have said that you've gone down to point C after 10 feet. Walk 8 feet at that 90 degree angle to point D. And now you notice that there's a direct line from point D through point P over to point B, where the tree is. So we can show that we form two similar triangles. We've got two right angles, that's angles A and C. We've got a pair of vertical angles at P. So what that means is we've got angle-angle similarity. Once we know we've got angle-angle similarity, we can find the length of the distance across the river, which I'll call R for river. So this side, the distance R, corresponds to distance CD, or line segment CD, and that's 8 feet. That's the corresponding side of the other triangle. We'll take another pair of corresponding sides. We'll take side AP, which is 15 feet, and put that over the distance for side CP, which is 10 feet. So now I've got R over 8 equals 15 over 10. I can multiply both sides of this equation by 8. I'm going to have R equals 8 times 15 is 120 divided by 10. 120 divided by 10 is 12. So the distance from point A, one side of the river, to point B, the other side of the river, is 12 feet. And again, we've done this with finding a pair of similar triangles. We found they were similar by angle-angle similarity. And then we used the similarity to find the unknown side. Okay, hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.